Hey, it's Ben from Digital Mastery and Masters Academy, and I want to show you a bunch of tips and tricks for how to remove sensor dust spots in your images. They happen when you change your lens a lot, and there might be a little breeze and a little few specks of dust get onto your camera sensor. And there are a bunch of different things we can do to find them easily, get rid of them, and deal with problems with going through that process. So let's dive in, and I'm going to be using Lightroom Classic, but much of what I do would also be possible with Adobe Camera Raw if you happen to prefer that. So let's dive in and get started. The first thing is when you go to the develop module in Lightroom, you might find the display of your image is less than ideal. If you look up here near the top, I'll just zoom in. Do you see it looks kind of pixelated and posterized? The reason for that is you might have a setting turned on in Lightroom. If you come up to the Lightroom Classic menu on the Mac or the Edit menu in Windows and choose Preferences, then under this choice called Performance is a choice called Use Smart Previews instead of Originals for Image Editing. If you happen to have that turned on, and I'm not saying it's a bad thing to have it turned on, then you'll probably want to click on your picture to zoom up, and that's going to cause it to load the actual original file, and it should eventually update what your screen looks like. Then you can click once again to zoom back out and you'll get a higher quality image. I'd usually do that before working on any noise reduction, sharpening, or getting rid of sensor dust spots. Now in this image, just glancing at my screen, it's often hard to tell where there might be a sensor dust spot, which shows up as usually a round, darker area. And it's gonna show up in an area that doesn't contain a lot of detail. So it's gonna be harder to see in areas with clouds, easier to see in straight blue sky, and I think I see one over here on the right. Well, if I want to get rid of that, I come over here just below the histogram when I'm in the develop module, and that's where I find right here the spot removal tool. You can type the letter Q as well to get to that tool. Then what I want to do is set it up properly for getting rid of these dust spots. To do so, in here I have this set to heal. And by the way, you can type Shift T to switch between those two settings if you would like. So Shift T if it's not already on heal. Then I make sure that my feather setting is at 0. Having feathering turned up is useful when using the clone setting. That's when you blatantly copy from one area and apply it somewhere else without trying to do anything special. But when you have it set to heal, if you turn the feather setting up, then it's not going to have control over the result all the way out to the edge of your brush. And it's not going to match then. So I want to have that turned all the way down and my opacity at 100. All right, then to adjust the size, I don't usually do it with this slider. If I'm on a thing with a mouse or a trackpad, I can use two fingers on my trackpad to make my brush larger or smaller. Or if I have a mouse with a little scroll wheel, I can use the scroll wheel on the mouse. If you don't have either, you're using a graphics tablet or something else, then you can use the square looking bracket keys on your keyboard. They're just above the return key on a Mac and for a US keyboard. Anyway, I'm going to get this so that my brush is big enough to actually not be touching the edge of that sensor dust spot. Instead, it's touching the blue sky that's around it, because it's going to precisely match whatever that little circle is touching. And therefore, if it was partially touching the sensor dust spot, we'd still get some of that brightness. And all I'm going to do is click and let go. And when I do, it picks another area to copy from, and it should get rid of our sensor dust spot. Now notice when I move my mouse away from my image, that that little overlay that's there disappears. That's only because I've changed a setting in Lightroom, which I like to have, because I like it anytime I'm over here by my adjustment sliders that I don't see the distraction of any of those. So in the lower left of my screen is a choice called Tool Overlay. And I think the default setting might be set to Always. I have mine set to Auto. And what auto means is anytime your mouse is outside of the image window and instead is over on one of these sidebars, that those little overlays will go away. But now at this point, if I look at my image, I can't tell if there's any sensor dust spots in here or if I just might have some dirt on my screen. Well, then in the lower left is a choice down here called Visualize Spots. And there's a keyboard shortcut for turning it on. If you just type the letter A, it will turn it on. By the way, the keyboard shortcut for the tool that I'm using, the spot removal tool, is the letter Q. And those two keys are right next to each other. One is above the other on your keyboard. So if you get used to having your two fingers over there, you can quickly type Q to get to this tool and then type A to turn on this overlay. Then we have this slider, which is going to change this view that we have. And this view often makes it easier to tell where you have sensor dust specs. And all you're going to be doing is looking for round circles that don't look like they belong in the image. And I'm seeing one right now, right about there. And so I can, if I want to, try to confirm that it's a sensor dust spot by staring at that area and typing the letter A or turning off the checkbox. And I can see a sensor dust spot there. It's very subtle. Or if I'm pretty sure that it would be and or there's no important detail up there, I can just click on it, just making sure that this circle is larger than the actual spot and get rid of it. Then I can adjust this some more. Now, sometimes you will have a lot more dust spots than what you'll be able to see with that particular choice. So there are some tricks to try to get the sensor dust spots to show up more prominently. And these are changes that you would make over here on the right side of your screen in the basic panel. It's not that I actually want to apply these to my picture and get the end results that they're going to give me, but I'm just going to use it to enhance this preview. And those are clarity and dehaze. I'm going to just remember what my setting was for clarity so I can easily get back to it later. Although I can always type Command Z to undo right when I'm done. And then I'm going to adjust clarity while I watch this preview. And if I crank it up, you're going to see that the view changes. And it's often much easier to look in the upper left of my screen. I can see two sensor dust spots, one at the tip of the cloud and one just to the left of it. Now, when you let go of the mouse button, this view will often update and it won't always look the same. But what I want to do here is just remember where those two sensor dust spots are and either come and deal with them right now or bring that clarity back down before doing so if I don't remember the setting I was at. I'm going to type Command Z, which is, should bring my clarity back down to what it used to be. And then I'm going to click here and I'm going to also get up here. Now here I probably want a smaller brush, so I'll get that by using my bracket keys. And I just need to make sure it's big enough to be touching the sky and the surroundings and not the sensor dust spot. And then it can copy from that other area. Now I'm going to turn off visualize spots. You can either turn off the checkbox or just type A. And you should see the last area that I retouched, and I'll just move my mouse into the image to see the overlay and then off the image to see if it looks appropriate. If it doesn't look appropriate, because this circle indicates where it was copying from and this circle is where it's applying it. Let's say it happened to choose from here. And as a result, if I wait a moment, it just doesn't look right. Well, if that's the case, there's a way to force it to pick a new spot without you having to do it manually. What that is on your keyboard near the lower right, at least of a US keyboard, there is a forward leaning slash key. It's the same as the question mark key, at least on a Mac, in the US. I'm going to press it. And each time I press it, it will force it to pick a new spot to copy from. And therefore, if it happens to copy from an area that has inappropriate detail, just hit that slash key until it picks a good spot. I usually think of it as three strikes and you're out. If it doesn't pick the right spot within three tries, then I come up here and just manually click and drag on this. You can also adjust the size of these circles after you've applied them. So if after you've applied it, you found that a little hint of the original is still there because the circle didn't touch outside of the sensor dust spot, instead is still making contact with it, then just grab the edge and you can change its size. So let's move to a different image. I'm going to type the letter G, which will bring me back to the grid in the library module. Or you could just click on the word library. And then let's come over to the next image. I'll type the letter D for develop, or if I want to go all the way into that spot removal tool, remember the keyboard shortcut for it was the letter Q. If I type that, it'll both bring me into develop and choose that tool. It'll also remember if I had my visualized spots checkbox turned on or not. Now, the main thing I want to mention about this image is I find that people are used to looking for sensor dust spots in skies because that's where they're the most common. But If you have areas that are out of focus, that's also areas that it would be very common to have sensor dust specks. So I'm going to type the letter A to see if I can find any sensor dust spots. I'll adjust this slider just a little to see if it helps, and I can see two of them in the image. I see one that's right up here. I need a slightly larger brush for it. And then I saw one other one up here. If I adjust the slider again, there, do you see it near the top of a tree? The main thing is it's round and therefore doesn't look like it quite belongs. I'll try to get just the right size circle, click, and anytime it's touching something else, I'll always turn visualize spots off by typing the letter A or turning off the checkbox. And then I'll move my mouse out of the image to see if it looks appropriate. And it actually looks, I'm not sure. I'm gonna hit the slash key to force it to choose from another spot, and I'll just stare up there to see if it looks any better. I think it looks fine. But then let's turn on visualize spots once more. And this time let's go over here and work with clarity and dehaze to see if it helps us find any more. I'll bring that up and just sometimes it'll make them more prominent. I noticed that there's some circles over here. I'm not sure if they should belong there. And I also see one over in here. And there might be one over there. So I'm going to choose undo because that's going to bring clarity back to where it was previously. And I don't remember what the setting was. And then I'll turn off visualize spots and I'll be critical of those particular areas. So one area was right over here. And I do see a slightly dark little circular object. So I'll see if I can get rid of it. And just move my mouse out of the area to see if it looks okay. And if it doesn't, I'll hit my forward slash key because I think it chose from another area of detail that wasn't quite appropriate. Then I'll look over here. And this round speck I'm thinking is a piece of dirt. So I don't think that is a sensor dust spot. But that helped me to know where to be critical of the image. It's very easy to get sensor dust spots in the areas that are out of focus in your picture. Detailed areas, it's very difficult to see them, and that's why you mainly see them in skies, even though they're probably in other parts of your image. If you're ever going to make any large prints, like you're going to print something that's at least 2 feet wide, I zoom up to 100% on my image and I scroll through the entire thing. And I notice then if I'm scrolling through my image that a sensor dust spot is easier to recognize when it's in motion because then I can tell it's not a piece of dirt on my screen. The dirt on my screen's not going to be moving when the picture is, and therefore I can separate it. And so that's one thing I do if I'm doing large pictures. All right, then there's a couple other things to consider. I'm going to switch to another image. And by the way, if you have more than one image you need to retouch and you're in one of them, here I'll type Q to go back into that tool, you're going to find that if you use the arrow keys to try to switch images, it's not going to switch images. Instead, it's going to be thinking about whatever spot you added last and it's going to nudge it a little bit left, right, up, or down, depending on which arrow you end up using. But if you hold down the command key, which is control in Windows, and that's what I'm holding down right now, then the arrow keys will work to switch between images and it will keep you in this tool. So I'll do command right arrow and that should bring me to my next picture. I'll type the letter A. Remember, A turns on visualize spots. And in this image, it looks like I've already done some retouching. So over on the right side of my screen, I'm going to hit the reset button right underneath my retouch tool, just so you can see what the image looked like to begin with. And you can see two very subtle looking little circles. So let's get rid of those. When it's in an open area of sky, the size of your brush is not all that important because there's no detail up there. It's when you get in tight against your image that it's going to be an issue. And I see one spot here. And you see it right over there. It looks like a circle and it's touching the edge of an object. So let's go take a look at it. I'll turn off visualize spots by typing A, and then I can just hold down the space bar on my keyboard and click, and that should zoom in. Now, on occasion, when you do the space bar and click to zoom in, it seems to get stuck on that tool. In this circle that would let you do your retouching isn't there anymore. Instead, you still have a hand. Or on occasion, it'll look like the zoom tool. When that happens, what you should do is just press the space bar again. It'll kind of toggle you between be in a hand where you can move around and using this particular tool. If on the other hand you see a magnifying glass, then you want to hold down both the space bar and the command key, control and windows. Just kind of tap them, and that will switch you into or out of the zoom tool. I don't know that it's supposed to work exactly that way because it seems to be inconsistent. Sometimes it gets stuck in that mode, sometimes it doesn't, and it's hard to predict. So let's dive back in. Now, it might be hard to see where that sensor dust spot is because I've been staring at the image for a while, but I think it's right here. If I just tap the letter A, okay, it looks like it might even be two of them sitting on top of each other. Well, when you want to retouch something like that, I'll go for the smallest brush that's going to allow me to get outside where this is touching, and you see the little corner down there, or the lower portion of the circle doesn't completely cover it. I can click and then drag to make a non-round shape. Then I'll let go and it'll choose where to copy from. And I can tell just from this preview that it probably doesn't look right because I can see that little white blob. So let's turn off the visualize spots checkbox. I'll just type the letter A. And yeah, I can see it's off a little bit. So I'm gonna then go to that forward slash, which is right by my shift key on a Mac on a US keyboard, and force it to choose from another spot. That's a second try, I'll do it once more. Third try did a little bit better. Now, if you find that it never picks the right spot, it just is always off, then you're going to have to come in here, click, and drag this to choose yourself. One thing that will seem to be non-intuitive is when you look at the area you're attempting to retouch, and I see that diagonal line that's in there, that's the edge of the object, right where the retouch is happening, I can tell it needs to be moved kind of up and to the right. But that's the opposite of the direction you want to drag your mouse. So I'm going to instead drag my mouse down into the left. And that's usually going to get that line closer to where it needs to be. But it's rather counterintuitive if you're not used to it. Then on occasion, I'll retouch an area like this, and I'll get it where this little edge right there just doesn't quite look right. And if that's the case, I'm going to go in and just put another little retouching dot there. The problem is that when you come over this, it thinks I want to move this spot when I move my mouse there. You notice it looks like a hand tool, whereas if I go up here, it thinks I want to add a dot. Well, if I need to retouch overlapping retouching that's already happened, and I find the hand showing up, what you can do is type the letter H all by itself. H means hide. And therefore, it thinks that you no longer want to grab those handles because they're not showing up anymore. And so then I'll get a smaller brush here, one just large enough for what I need, and I'll go to that area that doesn't look good. I'll click, and then it'll copy from another area. I can always type the letter H to no longer hide, or type H again if I want a clean view. Now, if I made enough of an overlap onto that image, instead of moving the area I'm copying from, I can just use the arrow keys on my keyboard to nudge the area I'm trying to fix to get it to line up. That often won't work when you've hidden the edge though. So remember H for hide if you need to do retouching that's really close to one area you've already retouched. If you click somewhere by accident, let's just say I clicked over here and didn't mean to, then if you want to get rid of any one of these, you're going to find that one of these will be active, the one that shows both circles. If you want to switch to a different one, you'll find a little pin there. If you click on the pin, that one will be active. If you want to delete one, click on it and then hit the delete key on your keyboard. Also, when you click on it, you can adjust the settings over on the right. You can change it from healing to cloning. And you can change the feathering of the edge, that's how soft the edge is, and if you can see through it or not by adjusting the opacity. And so if you want to delete one of these, just remember to click on it to make its little pin active, then you can hit the delete or backspace key to do so. If you have a bunch of areas that you need to delete, then what you can do as an alternative is hold down the Option key on your keyboard, which is Alt and Windows, and then just hover over the various spots you want to delete. And if you Option click on a spot, Option click on a spot, you can delete a bunch of them in fast succession. That is sometimes necessary when you work on complex images and you sync your settings between more than one photo. Let me show you what I mean. Here I have a series of images I'd like to work on, and I could think about it ahead of time in that all these images were shot one after the other. And so therefore, the sensor dust spots, the dust on your sensor is just sitting there. It's going to stay in the same position as you pan across a scene or take multiple shots. So those sensor dust specks should remain in the same spot between all these pictures, unless I change the lens of my camera, because that's when some wind might get in there and some additional dust is added, or the other dust that was there gets moved around. So why not select all the images, and then you can do your spot removal and have it apply to everything. So here's how you do that. I have one image selected already. I'll hold down the shift key and I'll get the last image of the sequence. And then I can click on one of the individual pictures, not the border around it, but the picture itself, to choose which one do I want to view while I'm doing my retouching. And so I'm going to pick this one. And then we can go to the develop module and go to our spot removal tool. I'll just type the letter Q, which is the shortcut for doing that. And it remembered my view that I was in previously, which is when I was zoomed up. Now, a couple tips here. You can press the space bar and click. That would zoom out. Or you can also zoom in or out using Command, which is Control in Windows, and then plus or minus. Plus and minus allows you to zoom in or out to different levels. If you're used to Photoshop, you might accidentally type Command 0, even though that is not a keyboard shortcut for zooming. But all that does is show or hide your histogram, so don't really worry about it. If you do and you notice something change on the right side of your screen, now you know what it is, and just type it a second time to get back to the way you were. I'm going to turn on the Visualize Spots checkbox by typing the letter A, or you can manually click the checkbox. And before I start retouching this image, there's a choice near the lower right of my screen that looks like a checkbox here, or a switch, I should say. And when it's turned on, next to it, it will say Auto Sync. When it's turned off, instead, it has the word Sync, which means manually sync your settings between images. Well, when that's in the up position, so it says Auto Sync, anything I do to this picture will happen to all the other images that are currently selected. And therefore, if I come down here and find all those sensor dust specks, I wouldn't want to retouch all those out from those other images manually. But now I can come in here. And this is when, if you have a blue sky, using a larger brush isn't that big of an issue most of the time. So you can go much faster when you have a larger brush. And so oftentimes people will do that. I'll caution you though, if you're ever stitching a panorama or working on multiple images like I am right now, because working with a large brush, and right there I saw it mess up, it just copied from another area that had a sensor dust spot. So I'm gonna hit the slash key on my keyboard to force it to pick from a different spot. And so I'm clicking here, and I'm not really evaluating the end result much. I'm mainly seeing, did the circle that it ended up with end up covering up another dot? And if it did, I hit backslash to force it to go to another area. And if that's all I do right now, I can go through this relatively quickly to get rid of these dust spots. There again, it picked from a bad spot, so I hit backslash. Now, there's a caution here. If you do this before adjusting your picture, then the sliders that you have in Lightroom are going to slow down a little bit, because it's going to need to think about all those sensor dust spots in updating them. If, on the other hand, you do this after you've adjusted an image and you've extensively moved the adjustment sliders, then this process of clicking and having it go to another area to copy from is going to be slower, because it has to think about updating all the adjustments you applied. So it's kind of a compromise. I think that might be one up there. And then if I want to see if there's any more, this is where I could come there and crank up clarity. It looks like it already was cranked up, and I'll crank up dehaze to see if it brings anything else into view. I think there might be a few touching one of the balloons near the lower right. I'll choose undo, because I didn't really want dehaze to be turned up that much. And right there, I'm going to evaluate that when I don't have this visualize spots checkbox on. So let's turn that off and maybe zoom up right in there. Remember Command plus, Control plus if I'm in Windows. And it's really hard to see if there's anything there. So I'm not going to worry about that. But now, I applied all these adjustments to all of the images that I just worked with, and I do see one sensor dust spot I still need to get rid of. It's right here. Let's zoom up to get rid of that one, And now this is where I really need to use a brush of appropriate size and see if I can get it where it's not touching that basket. And yeah, that's fine. But now I had all of these other images selected. And so if I wait long enough, do you see the sensor dust spots in this one? I just saw them go away. If I look over here, they just went away as well. And that's because it just took it a moment to go across all the other images and apply those changes. But I don't want to trust that they're in the right spot. Even with this small view, I can tell you that some of them are in the wrong spot. Look on the second image and look right there. Do you see a little bright spot? That's most likely a retouching that has happened that didn't copy from the proper area. So the next thing I'll do is I'll click not on an image, I'll click on the border around it. If you click when you have multiple images like this and you click on the picture itself, you're going to be switching what's known as the most selected image. It means that all the other images will still be selected. So if I go over and change this one little retouching dot in this, it will still affect all the other images. But if I click on the border around the image, or I click in the empty area down here and then back on just one picture, now I only have a single image active, and therefore when I go to develop, I'm not going to affect those other pictures. So let's go and type Q to get to our tool. And this one right here looks to either be the wrong size or copying from the wrong area. In this case, I'm guessing the size was the issue. I'm gonna then just scroll through this image and look for any other areas. Right there, it's messed up. So you can see where it copied from. It's obviously an inappropriate area. So I click on that to make it active. Then I can hit that backslash key to see if I can get it to pick a good area. If I can't, I might decide on this image, maybe I don't need this big of an area to change. So I'll just hit delete to start over on that one. And I think I can get a brush that is big enough to cover that without touching that balloon by going right about like that. And I'll simply redo the ones that don't look good. So I want to make sure that I look through here at each one of these. You don't have to be zoomed up like I am. I'll click to zoom out and I just glance around. And there's one that wasn't gotten in the other image. And let's see if there's any other areas that look messed up. Now, what I like to do is type, when I'm over the image, type H to hide, and then just type it again when I'm moving around. Right there, I can see an area that's on the horizon. And if I type H to hide, do you see the horizon looks a little lower there? So that one's not quite appropriate. I could first off delete it to see, can I even see the sensor dust spot? Or if I want to just fix it, I'll hit the backslash key as I stare at that area and see if I can get it to pick something that looks more appropriate. And if I can't, then I'll manually move that. But in this case, what I would do is delete it first to see, can you actually see the sensor dust spot? It's really hard to see in there. And so if you can't really see it, why spend the time going through and doing that? Now remember, when you're working here, if you want to switch to the next image, because we had a series of images, the arrow keys aren't usually going to work because it's going to be thinking about whatever spot you last retouched and it's going to be repositioning it. So I'm going to hold down the Command key, Control and Windows, and then press the right arrow. Now I'm on the next image and I can see a couple spots that don't look right. This one I think might need to be a little bigger. And I'm just looking around. Also right there, you can see a spot where there's just not a focus part of a balloon. What I would do is click and just get rid of it and see if the dust spot is something that is bad, and it is. It's kind of hitting the balloon. I don't like that. The problem here is I don't think there's an area from my surroundings that would be appropriate because it would need to have a dark area here and a lighter area there. So I think regardless of where it's going to copy from, it's not going to look right. So this is one of the very few times when I'm going to switch from using heal to using clone. What I'll do is get a small brush, I'm going to click right about here, and I'm going to drag like this, and I'm just trying to trace the edge of the balloon. Then I'm going to pick an area to copy from that is really close by because I need the brightness to be the same. So I'm going to drag it to right about there. And right now, anytime you have the word heal turned on or related to a tool, it's trying to perfectly match the brightness and color of what's all the way around the edge here. And right there on the edge, it sees this dark area and it's trying to match the color. When I slide away, you can see that dark area kind of blending in towards the right. Well, that's what you're going to get with Heal if it has the wrong source or it's just not appropriate to use Heal. So in this case, I'm going to switch to Clone. And now it's just doing a blatant copy of the area to the right, but when it does a blatant copy, it doesn't try to get it to perfectly match things, and right on that left edge, I see jaggies that don't look appropriate. So there, I'm going to take this setting called Feather, and I'm going to turn it up as I stare at the edge of the balloon. And that's going to soften the tool that I was using, and so then I can get it to have just as soft as an edge as the balloon. And so there's one instance when Clone was more appropriate than Heal. There just wasn't a good area in the surroundings to copy from. And so let's look around a little more. That one looks okay from here, but I would move on top of the image and just glance at where every circle is, see is it overlapping any object? And if it is, that's where I'd be critical. And it'd be down here on the horizon. You might not have noticed that, but suddenly you're going to have identical buildings and things. If you ever make a big print, then that might be noticeable and kind of embarrassing. So somebody can tell you did your retouch. So I just go to the next picture. And now it's going to remember the last settings I used. Most of the time, I wait until I click the mouse before I change them, because too often I won't realize that I have one of the dots in this image selected. And if I do, I'll be changing the settings for it. So what I'm going to do here is just click right there and then say, hey, I want to go back to healing and I want to get my feathering back to zero, because that's what's most appropriate for that type of work. This one on each one seems to be a little too small. It must have been one that was really close to one of the balloons. And again, right on the horizon, I doubt you're going to see that sensor dust spot, so I'll delete that one, and we can continue going through. And I should be done here in just a moment. Yep, that one's always too small. And the one on the horizon would be especially bad right now because we're replacing the edge of some balloons with some ground. So I'm going to delete that, and I can't tell that there's a sensor dust spot there. Now, when I'm getting rid of sensor dust spots, I will also get rid of other stuff. There's a balloon right up here on the very top edge of my picture. I can just as easily be getting rid of it. And I'll also, on occasion, just type the letter A to say, is this particular image have anything that the others didn't? You never know if a sensor dust spot got nudged or anything, so it's in a different position, and you might need to retouch it. So to go to the next image, Command right arrow. And let's just do a couple little touch-ups. I'm sure this one needs to be larger because it has on all the other images. And I'm sure this one near the horizon isn't copying from the completely wrong spot. So let's delete it. And right up here, we got a balloon going off the edge. And another one here. Remember, you can click and drag. So you don't have to just click and let go if it's a odd-shaped area. And there we go. Then know that this isn't the only technique for getting rid of sensor dust spots. Here you can see where I've retouched a lot of them out. Remember, if you see a low quality preview when you first view an image, that means it's most likely a smart preview and you have a preference turned on to make these sliders be more reactive, more interactive in speed. And if you just hold on the space bar and click on your picture to zoom in, it will usually say loading, and eventually it will go back to showing you the full quality view. Now, one thing that you won't be able to easily do with this technique is I can use this technique for getting rid of lens flare if it's across the sky. But in this case, I have lens flare inside of a starburst, which is where the sun is. And that's where this is going to be difficult, because what it should copy from to get rid of this little lens flare is something at that exact angle. And it can't rotate things. And therefore, unless there's another one of this exact angle, it's going to be difficult for it to copy from. So I do have a different video that I'll link to at the end of this one that shows you how I deal with getting rid of sensor dust spots and getting rid of lens flare on complex shapes like starbursts. Well, there you have it. A lot of tips on how to get rid of sensor dust spots. The biggest tip, though, is to clean your camera sensor. You can send your camera off to a manufacturer or camera store to have it cleaned. The problem with that is you put it off. If you really learn how to clean your camera sensor, then I would do it before going out on any big trip. And by doing so, you can avoid these sensor dust spots altogether. I'm Ben Wilmore. I'll see you next time.